Michael Manley to serve. One day more, 15.
Are you going by the machine or?
years. Murray. For the spoken to one, first up. Four, again, the choir. You also. For a late and 3, first set. Thank you. 15 seconds.
Why does it get the ground first?
Senator Carter. Gabe Blair. Here he is, like second chance. Long 15.
Thank you.
introduce.
He's doubling everything. Well, that's just like with you, Fiery. If you get to the second or third day, they keep raising your rate.
How have we done?
Two shanks.
Thank you.
when I see guys wait on their volley rather than attacking the volley and trying to punch up, that tells me they're not really confident in how to play the volley. Steps in a couple feet and just catches it perfectly. That angle, you know. Spank that forehand. Well, it's all about trajectory. 6 foot six. And here is a set point now for Query to go up two sets to love. Almost insurmountable lead. I really like the way Yanni played that second set. I just think that when it comes down to it, you take Query's serve and he's able to just get some very crucial free points off of it. Sort of snatches away any hopes somebody like a Yanni would have. And I really think for Yanni to be successful, he has to be better coming forward, and he isn't. You know, he's come in when he's in total control, but he's only been there 15 times.
Well, right now, he's got to be about 10 years younger. He's 28 years of age.
Yeah.
It doesn't happen too often.
No.
Getting a little, that's long in the tooth for a tennis player. A tennis player to improve himself.
But Fred, it doesn't look like a 28.
No, he doesn't. No, he does not. He's exactly right. You know, if you have a guess at his age, it's over 22.
glove. Too good. Got to be careful. Lose a 40 love game like this, that puts you way behind the eight ball. Corey much more relaxed now that he's up two sets to love. Afford to open up the shoulders a little bit. Love to three unforced errors. Now Corey's thinking he's got a chance to take this game. Well, certainly if Johnny wasn't able to hold on here, you'd have to say it's Katie bar the door, 40 love advantage, letting it slip away. Great point. It's an old one.
Katie by the door.
That means you can't get out. It's all over. Never heard it?
I've heard that five times today.
It's sort of synonymous with the fat lady getting up to sing.
Well, Katie's moved a little bit because of the juice.
Because it is a beautiful night, but the weather is having no impact on the performance of Michael Jani right now. Everything going the direction of Sam Querrey. Another missed volley, waiting for the ball to come to him. Not the way you were taught by Harry Hopman. Querrey from 40 love down steals that game.
Does steal the game, and Katie's by the door. One love, two sets to love, Querrey. Second set summary, the stats there. Querrey 59%, pretty good. Aces and Queen. Just 11 wins to 10 unforced errors. So really quite happy with the way he's performed today.
Chase review and
Perfect package.
Club 50 is required at 2 times to train.
He did a good job. He's very quick. He was on that one, but the execution not too good.
It's just hard to imagine, Fred, that Yanni's going to be able to recover, particularly after losing that 40-love game. I don't think you just get over it that quickly.
No, I think it takes pretty good imagination if you think he's going to get out of this one. But stranger things have happened. That's what makes this, that's why, as you mentioned, that's why they play these events, these matches.
Just too many unforced errors. With that one, no. Michael Yanni, 41 unforced errors. And for Corey, it's been sort of a good balance. 22 winners, 18 unforced errors. He's plus four, but Yanni, you know, 26 winners, so he's minus 15. And that's the demise, really, for this American.
Another chase review. Challenge there. And boy, Pete's got a big smile on his face there. That one.
Just too many unforced errors, Fred, for a guy like Yanni. You know, you just can't give that many away.
44. This is only the first couple of service games here, but 53% first serves in the match. When he gets that in, though, that's the big stat. When the first serve goes in, he's winning 85% of them. That's a kind of like that, just to add to the injury of Yanni. Just that's really good. 3-1, Katie's by the door and it's barred.
Visit usopen.org, your exclusive online home for real-time scores and stats, daily video highlights and press conferences, official US Open merchandise and much more. The official tournament website, usopen.org. Well, he certainly is in cruise control right now. Just gotta be careful not to get too lax.
Exactly right.
And remember, Yanni lost a game like this earlier in this set where he led 40 love. Hopefully he would have learned his lesson. Well, Fred, it's been a respectable showing from Yanni, but I guess at the age of 28, you're not really looking for a respectable showing. You're looking to pull off the victory.
Well, I think he's done a super job. This is his first toughest player he's played. He's come through the qualifier. I think he's done an excellent job to get into the main event. That's another huge step. His rank is about 240. 28 to 28.
Came in here actually at 253.
Yeah, his ranking right now is 248, and that's a big step for him to come here and then play on Louis Armstrong Stadium, first round match, big crowd. He's never played in front of a crowd like this. Yeah, great effort.
No, he's trying to prolong it as long as he can.
Oh, exactly. Enjoy it while it's there. May never happen again, but it gives him some confidence to go back out, and he'll be a better player with this experience when he gets back out there into that challenge. So.
That well, that wide forehand.
Well, I've said that beforehand.
Yeah. On big points. Yanni's got to maybe be thinking about that a little bit. Curry's used it so effectively when he's been in trouble. Look how quickly from glove 30, I mean, doesn't even get into a point.
Well, they're the ones that the experience is there. Second serve, 15 30. We talked about that earlier.
Several of those aces actually coming on those break points. He's faced four of them. And then it seems like he just gets more confident. When you don't get your service broken, you tend to become or feel invincible. But that's what I mean by teasing them. I know it's not intentional, but when guys get like love 30 or 30, 40 several times and they never get a chance to get to the point, it's like you're giving them a little sniff and then you're just pulling it back. And it's cruel. Flawless. Got the shoulders turned, got the racket head going forward, came around the outside of the ball. It's finding the happy balance, isn't it, Fred?
Yes, it is.
Shot right now, Johnny, and that really favors Query. it's not high enough. We're just a couple games away from advancing in the second round. Let's take a look at the draw of Sam Querrey. If he is able to get through this match, we'll take on the winner of a match between Duty Cella and Kevin Kim. Duty Cella, the Israeli, Kevin Kim, former UCLA Bruin. Is able to come through his next round, he could potentially meet French Open finalist in the third round, Robin Soderling. Just got to try to keep the ball a little bit deeper. That's just too easy. Johnny holds on. Still trailed by 4-3 and two sets to love.
What'd you say yesterday? The total was pretty close to 60,000 in the day and night session.
Biggest ever. Set a record for opening day. Yeah, sure. Kova had actually partial rotator cuff tear. And that is a serious, serious injury.
Just hanging in there, hanging around. And it really worked for him in the second set, 7-5, he lost it.
Didn't do anything with the ball. Querrey tended it. Not only would Querrey pass it with that, but I think pretty much anybody in any level of tennis is going to be able to hit a passing shot with a ball hit in the middle of the court like that.
Oh, you have that right where he wanted it. He struck it well. Right on the top of the toe. So, dirty all.
This is the tease factor again. So he's just letting the guys stick around. And then snuffs it out. Nice hands there by Kerry. But it's all made possible because of that big first serve. He's able to dictate play and control the point.
Good pick serve. Around shoulder height. Ever closer to the finishing line.
I think it's all up here, Fred, for Corey to try to get off this court in a good fashion. Go away with a good feeling. He can break, and then he'll leave this court. And even though the match was, you know, somewhat close, it can leave Thane that broke twice in that third set.
He's going to go away with a good feeling, right? He's going to go away with a win. Coming into the last 4 or 5 weeks, he's done well. Hasn't served particularly well over the match as he progresses through the tournament. He's going to need to pick that service percentage up. But the big thing is he's been in trouble with it. Around the top 20 in the world and compete he has.
He's just been keeping the unforced errors down to a minimum. He hasn't been able to do so. And without miss, Yanni's 49th error. Corey is finally at match point. Fighting like he believes. It's challenging. Can't get Lynn Welsh's attention, though. It's hard to challenge if the umpire doesn't really want it. So if he's correct on this, well, it's deuce. He's got nothing to lose. You can't take him home with you. Oh, it's low. converts the two match points. He's kept it more than respectable. But it is Sam Querrey with a two set to love advantage. And after that time, Sam Querrey serving for it. Exactly what he did, and now he has three more match points, but on his own serve. That'll do it. Efficient type of performance from Sam Querrey.
Oh, he's got to be really happy with that. He would not go away. He gives Yanni some credit for keeping